I've been so alone ever since I left the tribe. That's just how it goes, cause I like the lonely vibe. Yo, what is up guys, SurgicalGoblin here, and welcome to this new episode. In today's video, I'm going to play with this Mortar Miner deck. It's a really interesting deck in my opinion. Also off meta, like you don't see it a lot. In my opinion, barely, like never. And yesterday, if you watch CCGS Europe, by the way, I played yesterday. I'm 3-0 right now, so I'm leading right now. I'm number 1 in the top 10. But I used this in one of my games. I actually won with this deck as well. And many of you guys requested on Twitter, like, make a video about it. I tweeted, should I do it? And so many people said, yes, yes, make a video, please. I don't know how to use this deck. So right now, I'm 9-0 in the Grand Challenge. I will try to get 12 wins live with this deck. But let me first explain a little bit about this deck, because it's quite, like, interesting in my opinion. Like, it's quite unique. So the Mortar is not really your win condition, but of course, like, people see it as a win condition. Most of the times, you try to get like an elixir advantage, or you try to get value out of your troops, like counter push with your bowler, ice wizard, mega minion, whatever, and then you play your Mortar. Like, I would never start off just placing my Mortar down. So first you're trying to build up like a sort of an army, I would say. I don't know how to describe it. I guess an army, like just a counter push, like a push. And then you drop the Mortar, like when you know you either get value out of your troops or you're up an elixir. And you also have the miner just to chip away. Fireball, really solid versus two musketeers. Two musketeers are still quite good in this meta. So tornado, two musket, or tornado fireball fully counters two musketeers. And it's also just good to send in miner fireball or whatever. I'll just play this deck and then you guys will see how I use it. And of course, if I see any tips or mistakes, what people or what you guys shouldn't do or should do, I would definitely mention that. So let's give him the thumbs up and the good luck. So I would never start off with a Mortar just because he could like punish me or whatever. So I will either be patient or start off with an Ice Wizard. I think I would just start off with an Ice Spirit and see how he reacts. So let's drop the Ice Spirit, Ice Wizard in the back. Right now we cycle to Ice Spirit. We can send in an Ice Spirit to the right side just to chip away, just to see if he decides to defend that. Looks like he will defend that, and looks like this guy is using the Hulk Rider deck. He could be using something else. He actually has Miner, and if he doesn't place it in a spot where you can where you can tornado it, which is here on this exact tell where I have my Miner right now, if he places it on that tell, he or you can tornado it. But if he places it in any other tell from here to here, especially like here, it would be really easy, but you can tornado it. So that's something you should be like looking for. And right now I will just send in a miner to chip. I will not use my Mortar yet. I'm not sure if I use my Mortar early in the game versus Baron yesterday. I used it versus Baron, but right now I'll just slowly chip away. He cycled back to his bets, and I think this guy might be using a balloon cycle with miner. So let's use the Ice Spirit for the bets. One does survive, but he's spending quite a lot. He's quite aggressive. So I guess with the Mega Minion over here, we could be able to make a counter push. Let's say he goes in with a Minion Horde or something. We can, let's see. I want to tornado this balloon. And then I will drop an Ice Wizard in this lane. Just to make sure it actually goes for the right side. Knowing that we could like cycle to Miner. And then have an Ice Wizard. And as you guys can see, the Mortar, I believe 2 shots. And whenever a Mortar, I would say get 1 shot. It's a good Mortar. Especially because they are always trying to defend it. So we could try to fireball for his bets, but I'm fine with, he actually goes with a Mega Knight. I'm glad we didn't fireball, otherwise we might have been like in a bad situation to defend. But right now we can just drop a bowler over here. I have the fireball ready for his minions or bets. Actually, I will try to Ice Spirit this. There you go, perfect Ice Spirit hitting all the bets. And this is again a good example of when I have a counter push going. Tornado is so good versus Balloon. I can just tornado it. I will not risk it. I'll just drop the Ice Wizard on the right side again. And as you guys can see, the Mortar is locked on. And the Mega Mean and the Bowler, like, he didn't have that much Elixir, I guess. So the Mortar is actually locked on. Let's try to cycle to another Mortar to keep the pressure. It will actually go with a Mega Knight. I can drop the Bowler in the left lane, knowing that the Bowler will take aggro from the Mega Knight. Let's say he dropped something after the Bowler died. Or after the Mega Knight died, I mean, the Bowler is still there in the left lane, knowing that we already have the right side in fireball range. But it looks like the Mega Knight is getting a lot of value. Mega Knight is quite strong, but we are able to take this win quite easily. Let's drop the fireball. We could even tornado here, but it's not needed. The Mega Minion will already counter the balloon. So let's give him the good game, well played, and a thumbs up. And if you're patient enough with this deck, I would say this deck doesn't really have a counter. Sometimes I struggle versus a really good lockbait player, because they can always like try to
Switch placements so you can tornado it. Let's say you pull the tornado, the goblins all the way to the back, and they put the goblin barrel in front of the tower. You're not able to fully counter it because the tornado doesn't kill goblins anymore. And let's say you fireball the barrel, like it's a negative elixir trait, and you won't be able to cycle that quick. Of course, the bowler could get some value, but then again, they have the Inferno Tower for value. So I would say Lockbait is one of the hardest matchups. But other than that, I don't think this deck has a really hard matchup if you play well. Especially patience is really key with this deck. I would say with any deck, but especially with this deck, like trying to get value out of your troops, etc. So again, I would just start off with an Ice Spirit at the bridge, see if he drops something. And this here, I will drop my Mortar, just because he spends 6 Elixir. Let's say he will counter, for example here, he will counter it. I will send in a Miner to the Collector. He does have an Ice Spirit, really well played on the Ice Spirit. And I think I will try to activate the King. Maybe it's too late, but I think we should be able to. Ooh, wow, that was really bad, almost, but because of the Mortar was locked on the Knight, it damaged it, so I couldn't activate it anymore. That's really bad played by us and well played by him. And he has Hawk Rider. I think this is Hawk Rider 2 Musketeer, so well played by him for sure. The Bowler will almost go down, but we do have a counter push right now, so let's go with the Mortar. And I think he has 2 Musketeers, but I don't think he will drop that if we have a Mortar and a Bowler there, which are both splash. So let's go with the Ice Wizard, and let's have the Ice Spirit ready for this side. Hopefully we're able to kill the minions and let the Mortar lock on the tower, because right now it's locked on the Knight. So let's see, looks like he will go in with the Ice Wizard. I will actually tornado it all back, because he also has a Goblin Gang there. I still think this will deal a lot of damage. Wow, that's unfortunate. I'm not playing, this was a really bad start with the misplacement tornado. That definitely cost us the game. I should not have tried that. Because I didn't know he had like Hawk Rider. I thought he had 3 Musketeers. But let's see. I think we should be able to recover. Let's go in with a Minor Fireball. I think he will try to defend it. So let's see if he has anything. There you go. There's his Knight. So we had the Fireball Collector in the tower, and the Miner's chipping away. I feel like we needed some damage, and right now we could be, or we maybe are able to get back into the game. I don't think so, because the right side tower is already down to 248. But let's see if we are able to get something done. So let's go with the Ice Wizard in the back, just to like slowly build something up. I think I will try to... I think this is a bad move. Yeah, a really bad move. Wow, that was... I'm not playing well this game, I don't know why. The tornadoes are definitely failing all the time. I was trying to save the tower by freezing the Hawk Rider and then pulling it to the King Tower, but I didn't succeed in that. So let's see. I definitely want to attack. I will try to ignore most of the muskies over here and just put a bowler. Actually, I need to put a Mega Main, otherwise I might get 3 ground. So let's see. I will put a tornado in this lane. I definitely want the Mortar to lock on, but I think we might get 3 ground. Let's see if the Ice Wizard brings it in Ice Spirit range. Yes, the minions are, but looks like the Mortar is not even locked on the tower. It's still shooting at Musketeers, and I think that is good game. Let's go with the Bowler over here. Let's Fireball. Let's try to not get 3 ground, I guess. We could Fireball over here, but it's still good game. No way we can get that damage with just the Minor chip. So definitely well played by him. Really bad played by us. Good game. Well played. And a thumbs up. Sorry guys for playing that bad. I don't know, with the tornadoes, that was really poorly played by me. But let's try to focus again. 10-1 right now. So definitely, like, we weren't in a really bad situation. It wasn't that we had to win. So we need to win 2 more times. And we could possibly still lose 1 game. Of course, I don't want to lose. But let's see. So let's give him the thumbs up and the good luck. And let's see what this guy is using. So again, I would just start off with the Ice Spirit, just to see if he drops something, just to see if he reacts to that. And then we could react on his move. Looks like he will take the damage. He will go with minions in the back, so let's go with Ice Wizard all the way in the back too. If he, let's say he sends in a Miner or anything, we could either block it with the Bowler or go with the, well, he actually goes with the Golem. So many players make the mistake to go with a Mortar right now, but in my opinion, you should not go with a Mortar. Of course, like, trying to punish is good, but trying to like defend really well is better in my opinion. Just because if you are able to defend well, you can just get such a good counter push. Of course, I'm giving him lightning value right now. I will fireball the main horde, hopefully in time. Let's go with the Ice Spirit. Maybe I want to tornado, but I think it's too late already. Like, the bowler, the Mega Main, and the tower are dealing so much damage. So this is a good moment to counter push. Like, people... Ooh, wow. I will actually... Ooh, am I too late? Oh wow, against such a bad tornado, guys. But I did damage the Musketeers, and I think with the bowler hit, it will kill them. Yeah, so I guess that's not too bad. I will go with an Ice Wizard and I will let the Musketeer on the right side hit, knowing that we deal some damage to the left side. And he already dealt some damage to the left side too. So let's go in with a Mega Main and a Miner. We have Ice Wizard still there. So let's see what he drops for this. Actually goes in with a Batarang and then minions. Interesting counter. Quite a lot of Elixir there. Let's see if we can take down some of those units. The Ice Wizard is there. One Barbarian went down. And I think with the help of the Ice Spirit, we are able to fully counter this, this counter push. So the Ice Spirit on the minions. And I think the Barbarian will die to the tower as well. Okay, so that's good. And so he has Golem, two Musketeers, which is quite annoying, I guess. Golem is good for his Mortar, but he doesn't have a big spell. So we can just basically stack our troops without him getting like poison value or lightning value. Unless he has a really strange variation of this deck. But I believe this deck doesn't have any big spells at all. So let's go with a Fireball on the main horde. Maybe we should not have dropped the Fireball there. But I think it's worth it for sure. Let's go with the Ice Spirit as well. Let's say he goes in with two Musketeers. I guess we could try to tornado it into the bowler, like splash damage. But let's go with another bowler. And I think we should be able to just fireball the muskies over there. Or just let it be. Maybe just let it be. Actually, I will fireball over here because he dropped the Batarang to distract. I will go with a tornado. Just to make sure the goblin gang dies. And then we can drop an Ice Spirit for the musketeer on this side. So he dropped the main horde quite well played. But the Mega Main and the Ice Wizard were actually able to finish off the the main horde. Let's send in the miner to chip away. And we're looking really good right now, guys. The miner's chipping away. The Ice Wizard is still there. And we could just cycle to miner, I think. Let's go with a tornado and fireball the musketeers. Okay, let's fireball them. Let's cycle to miner. Drop a Mega Man for his Batarang. And it should be a good game. The miner is there. We still have an Ice Wizard, Mega Man. And this is definitely a good game. The Ice Wizard is locked on as well. So definitely good game. Well played, and a thumbs up. Quite a good matchup for me, I guess, because we were able to stack troops. Like, he didn't have a poison spell, lightning or whatever. So we could just basically stack our troops, and our defense is quite good. Of course, we had tornado and fireball as well. So 11-1 right now. Let's go for the 12-1. Hopefully, we're able to get it. That just shows it's quite a good deck. Like, in my opinion, it's a really good deck, actually. Maybe we could even face Lockbait and try to beat it. Like, I could show you guys how to beat it. Of course, it's a really hard matchup, but like any deck or any matchup, I would say you're able to win it if you play it really well. So let's see, searching for opponent right now. And let's see, maybe I will just cut or edit it when I found the opponent, and then I will be back at you guys. Okay, guys, looks like we do have an opponent right now. Let's give him the thumbs up and the good luck. So this is the game for the 12 win. 11-1 right now, so we could even lose the game, but of course I don't want to lose, especially we already lost one game in this episode. So he starts off with bets. I would just start off with an ice wizard in the back, and he also, I think this is a bet tornado because the Ice Wizard is there. No, we still activate the king, which I wanted to do. I wasn't sure if the Ice Wizard would damage it enough, so they wouldn't activate the king. But we do activate the king, which you really want in this matchup, because they have Goblin Barrel. You really want to have the king tower to help you. So we fireballed his let's see, he goes in with a miner. So we fireballed his Electro Wizard just to chip away, just to deal some damage. Right now he went with a miner and a goblin gang. We were able to defend that with Mega Main Bowler. Of course we overspend on that. Like, he spent 6 elixir, we spent 8 elixir, but right now he still needs to defend this. And he goes in with, that's interesting, he goes in with a Mega Knight, so he has Mega Knight over here. Let's try to pull the Mega, oh wow, the bet. Oh wow, really well played on his Goblin Barrel placement, because one Goblin was still able to chip away in the tower. I didn't really care about pulling the Mega Knight to the King Tower, of course it would chip away, but it's not super low or anything. But the Goblin Barrel placement on his part was really good. He placed it on the corner, so I couldn't pull it to the King Tower, and I knew the King Tower was locked on the Mega Knight to like tank it, so that is why I pulled it there. So let's see, he has Mega Knight, Lockbait, I guess he has Rocket. I think I'll just try to bait out the Rocket over here, or maybe he doesn't have the Rocket because he has a Miner. If he does have a Rocket and he uses right here, I will definitely be going with a Mortar. If not, I will probably also go with a Mortar, because I guess he doesn't have that much besides a Mega Knight. And if he drops a Mega Knight, he basically spends all his elixir. So we could try to drop a Mega Man and let's kill it as soon as possible. So let's see, let's go in with the Tornado and the Ice Spirit. The Ice Wizard and the Bowler should be able, also with the help of the Mortar, should be able to finish off the Mega Knight. I will drop an Ice Wizard as well. And let's see what he drops. So he decides to zap over here, but the Mortar still gets one hit on top of the tower. The Ice Wizard will probably die to the Miner and the Mega Knight. But I think, ooh, wow, will that get a jump? Oh wow, that was so close. I was about to say, wow, that will get a jump. But luckily for us, it didn't get one. So that's good for us, I guess. Let's try to go in with another Tornado. Trying to get like the damage on the Electro Wizard as well. And the Mega Knight actually jumped on the Mortar. But the Mortar still gets one hit on the tower, which is really good for us. And let's go in with another Mortar. Let's go in. Ooh, wow. Maybe I need the Fireball. I do need the Fireball. Hopefully not too late. He spent a lot of Elixirs, so maybe he's not able to go with a Mega Knight. Maybe now he is, because he used quite, or he didn't use a unit for quite a while. But the Mortar is locked on. We have a Miner there chipping away. Let's go with the Ice Wizard. Oh wow, that was so close. I needed to drop my Ice Spirit, and this might be good game because the Mega Knight is there tanking. Also for the Goblins, he will send in a Miner. Let's try to Fireball this. Wow, we missed the Fireball. Well, I'm playing quite bad in this episode. I don't know why. Definitely well played by him. Good game. Well played. And a thumbs up. And hopefully we're able to get the 12 wins. If not, that will be really bad. Losing 3 times in one episode. I don't think I've ever done that before. But sorry for playing this bad, guys. But let's try to really focus right now. Let's give him the thumbs up and a good luck. And hopefully we are able to finish the episode with a 12 win. And hopefully also a legendary. But if not, that would be really bad. This guy is laughing. Let's see what he's playing. Let's start off with a Mega Minion. He starts off with the Bats. He supports it with a Hawk Rider. I will go with a Tornado and I will drop my Ice Spirit to counter his Bats. So the Hawk Rider will activate the King Tower, which is good for us. And now we can go with a Mortar. Knowing he just attacked us with a Hawk Rider. Let's say he had the Hawk Rider still in cycle. The Mortar is not a good play because the Hawk Rider can get a lot of value. But let's see. So the Mortar actually splashed on top of the tower. The Electro Wizard went down. I don't think he has Bats in cycle. And wow, the Mortar splashed again. That's really good for us. I don't want to place my Mega Minion too high. Let's say he cycles back to Bats. We can use the Ice Wizard to... Yeah, there you go. The Ice Wizard right now should be able to splash those units. There you go. That's what I mean. Let's drop the Ice Spirit to distract the P.E.K.K.A. Let's go with another Mortar as soon as we can. But of course, we know he has P.E.K.K.A. Hawk. So we know that he has Lightning. So I will wait until the Ice Wizard is a little bit further. So he doesn't get that much Lightning value. So let's place the Mortar right now. So now he can't hit the tower, the Ice Wizard, and the Mortar. So let's actually go with Bowler right here to like distract the Hawk Rider. Also go with a Mega Minion because he spent quite a lot of Elixir. I know he has Lightning, but if he Lightnings right now, he doesn't have the Elixir because he spent and the Hawk Rider and he spent Electro Wizard, I mean. Hopefully the Ice Spirit is able to hit the Bats, and it did hit the Bats. Not all of them, one is alive, but the Bowler will hit the Goblins as well. So we're playing this quite well in my opinion. The tower is down to 1700, a little bit less. And our tower is quite healthy. We took one Hawk Rider hit, but of course our King Tower is activated. So we know our defense will be really good. He's giving us the good luck. I don't know why. Let's give him the thumbs up. And let's go with the Ice Wizard. I think if he has Lightning, we are able to stack Bowlers. Because the Bowler, like, of course takes the Lightning hit, but doesn't die to it. So let's see, let's Fireball the P.E.K.K.A., let's Fireball, oh, he actually has Poison, I don't know if that's good for us. I mean, the Ice Wizard doesn't die to Poison, so I guess that's good. And the Ice Wizard will actually splash, wow, let's go with a Tornado over here. I think that's quite a good Tornado. We do need to drop the Bowler as well, because the Ice Golem actually allowed the Hawk Rider to not get pulled that far by the Tornado. But the tower is activated, of course the Hawk Rider will not get too much damage, only 2 hits I believe. Let's go with a Mega Main Ice Spirit to kill this Hawk Rider. We send in the Miner to the Electro Wizard. Let's see if the Mortar and the Bowler, etc., will be able to finish that off. Maybe the Mortar right now. Yeah, there you go. The Mortar will finish that off, so that's good. We get Fireball over here on the Ice Wizard, or the Electro Wizard, I mean. The Electro Wizard will go down, and the Ice Wizard is actually tanked for the Mega Main. Wow, that got 2 hits. Wow, that's insane. And I think we should be able to finish that off quite soon. Let's go with a Mortar. Let's go with a Miner to cycle. He spent a P.E.K.K.A., so he definitely doesn't have enough to counter this. Let's see if this is enough. I don't think so. I'm not sure how much. No, 56 HP. Let's go with the Ice Wizard. Let's go with Tornado all the way to the back. Hopefully we are able to get the Ice Wizard to tank. Wow, those Goblins. Wow, this was actually closer than I thought. Maybe I should not have tried to fireball right away. That was quite risky. Good game, well played, and thumbs up for sure. Quite an interesting matchup in my opinion. Backup Poison Hawk Rider. I would say 50-50 because after Tornado, like, we were able to activate the King Tower. At the end, I actually made it really close by fireballing right away. Like, I was, I would not say dominating all game, but I was playing really well all game. And at the end, I almost threw the game. So, luckily, we were able to get the 12th win. So, let's see what we are going to get from this chest. 22k gold, always nice. Spear Goblins, Goblin Hut, Hawk Rider. I already have it maxed. Guards, Tombstone, Elite Barbarians, Zap Spell, Skeleton Army, Musketeers, which is really nice, Tesla. Ooh, 50 Mega Minions. Look at the Mega Minion, almost max. That will be my second max rare if I get it max soon. Fireball is also pretty high. And looks like we will not get a Legendary, but we do get a lot of Main Horde. And 8 clones. Wow, that's a pretty bad epic, but overall quite a good chest in my opinion. Especially the Mega Minion and the Musketeer. I'm quite happy with that. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I hope you guys liked this deck. Last episode was quite off meta. Also, I didn't upload yesterday because, as I mentioned in the video before, I was playing CC Jess, so I couldn't record and upload a video and play CC Jess at the same time. So I'm sorry for that, guys. But I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did enjoy this episode, smack that like button. If you're not subscribed to my channel yet, feel free to subscribe. And I hope to see you in one of my next videos. Bye, guys.